Welcome to Triratna Day 2024. So my name is Nyanadara and I'm standing just outside the London Buddhist Centre in the courtyard. And very soon we'll be joining the London Buddhist Centre Saturday morning class. Just before we do that, I thought I'd just tell you what we've been doing so far today. So it's 10:30 in the morning in London. And this morning at 8 o'clock in the morning, we were in Monmouth Street in central London, the very place that our movement started in 1967 on this very day, the 6th of April. And after that, we heard a little bit from, well, quite a bit actually, from Mahamati and Nagabodhi, who were at Ergian House, talking about some of the treasures in the exhibition at Ergian House. So our movement started in Monmouth Street and the first few years of its life. And for a while there, it was homeless. There was no centre for a little while. I believe there was a fire in the basement in Monmouth Street that meant that we needed to find a new home. A little while after that, we were in Archway in North London. And then this Victorian fire station, which maybe Sangadara could give you a little picture of, just up there. So yeah, that fire station was converted into what is now the London Buddhist Centre, which is one of five centres that we have in the London area. So we've got a centre, the West London Centre, which is in that direction, the North London Centre, which is in that direction, the Brixton Centre, which is in that direction, and the Croydon Buddhist Centre, which is even further in that direction. So it's one of a mandala of centres within the Greater London area. Yeah, so that's it became a real, this place here became a focus of quite a bit of activity. Now, what we're going to do in the next session is we're going to have a little bit of a look around the area and some of the communities and businesses which are associated with the London Buddhist Centre. But what we're going to do now is we're going to practice meditation. So the theme for the day is transforming, it's transformation. Which is sort of amazing gust of wind there for a second, is transformation. And of course, the Metta Bhavana is a practice that we've done right from the early part of our history. It was taught right from the beginning. And it's very much a practice that's associated with transforming the mind. So we're going to be practicing the Metta Bhavana in just a minute, led by Manjusiha. And within that, there's going to be some rejoicings. He'll explain how that's going to happen when we get there. So we're going to be practicing with friends online and also friends in the Shrine Room at the London Buddha Centre. We're also going to be hearing from Future Dharma Fund about work that they do, and they're going to be inviting us to contribute to that work. So what I'd like to do now is to hand over to Surya Gupta, who is the chair of the London Buddha Centre. Right now she's actually in New Zealand on the other side of the world. Surya Gupta, I'd like to hand over to you now.
Great, thank you. Hope you can hear me. I don't know if they're hearing me in the actual class itself at the centre, but I just want to welcome you all to the London Buddhist Centre. I'm really delighted that we're going to get a chance today to have a look around the centre. You'll get to see our cafe, our shops, and of course the centre itself, and you can see the class there online. So I think the class is saying, can you say hi? Can you you're hearing me now? Yeah, brilliant. So welcome everyone. Yes, as Nanadara said, I'm not actually at the building today. Normally I am, but I'm actually in New Zealand, Aotearoa. Is a Maori name, the original name for New Zealand, and that's where I am. And I'm here, I've been here on a solitary retreat. I've been doing a retreat at the Sudarshana Loka, which is a retreat centre here. And it's quite a fantastic, quite stunning location. I've never sort of been on a retreat centre like it, sort of in the middle of the rainforest. And there's also a great stupa there that contains the sort of relics of one of Sangharakshita's teachers, one of our teachers in our lineage. And it has a very strong, palpable atmosphere. So if you're ever this side, then I do really recommend you visit that retreat center. So I was there, and I've also been meeting up with Sangha members here, people in the community here in Auckland, the Auckland Buddhist Center. In fact, I led a day for the Auckland Buddhist Center, actually also called the Creative Fire of Transformation. So also on transformation, and we also started the day with the Metta Bhavana practice. So it's nighttime now where I am, which is partly why I've got the background. It's nighttime on the other side of the world from the London Buddhist Center, and I'm just really warmly welcoming you all to the center, to this day. You know, what I've really appreciated really is that, you know, we do have this international community. So I'm very much, you know, chair of the London Buddhist Center, but I'm also a friend now of Auckland, you know, Buddhist Center, you know, the other side of the world. And, you know, that feels certainly something that wouldn't happen without the way that the Truvatna has been set up, you know, with these, you know, different locations around the world, different practitioners, but very much sharing, you know, a sort of common language and a common values and common ethos. So I've been very enriched here, been very welcomed here. I'm going to be back soon. So I'll be back in the London Buddhist Center Shrine Room, you know, very soon. And I'm just been enjoying my time here and enjoying sending photos back to the team and to friends in London of my stay. So I'm going to now introduce you to Manjusiha. So Manjusiha is there. I see, Manjusiha, that you've already been you know, connecting with the class there in front of you, and you're going to be leading, Manjusiha is going to be leading all of us in a Metta Bhavana practice, a practice of loving kindness. And Manjusiha is a, you know, great meditator, very keen practitioner. He's also an author as well, got a great mind, very warm, friendly, you know, man. And I really enjoy when I've worked with Manjusiha. Hello, Manjusiha. I'm speaking to you. I've really enjoyed working with you, and I'm just very pleased to see that you're going to be starting us here today in practice. And I also very much like your shirt. looking very good. So yes, please enjoy the session. Enjoy the London Buddhist Center. You know, what I recognize from visiting other places around Truvatna is that, you know, every center is quite unique. It's got its different history, you know, but there is this common, you know, language, common ethos, and many friendships that go between the centers as well. So yeah, I'm very much looking forward to you leading, Manjusiha. And to the rest of the day as well. So yeah, I'll say goodbye, and you know, yeah, enjoy the session.
Your day. So yeah, fantastic to see you. Thank you so much for the introduction. Thanks for the comment about the shirt, which I did put on specially for today's festivities. So we're going to do the Metta Bhavana practice. And we'll start shortly. I'm just going to say a few words of introduction. Just to say again, it's obvious. So there's some of us in person in the room who will be meditating together, and online as well. For those online, maybe I'll just describe a bit the London Buddhist Centre, because some of the people online won't have been to the centre. I mean, we're actually meditating in, it's an old fire station in the East End of London, a Victorian fire station, and the room we were meditating in actually was the room where the fire engines used to be. They used to sort of go out through these two entrances here, which are now windows. And also the rest of the centre, so being an old fire station, there was accommodation above, so we now have two communities directly above this shrine room. We have other communities above the restaurant, and at some point, the local estate agents started calling this part of London the Buddhist village. And I like that, actually. I think it is a Buddhist village. There's so many sort of people around practicing and part of our community, or just sort of dipping in. I just wanted to sort of set a little bit of the scene for those online. We're going to do this practice called the Metta Bhavana. Probably some people in the room may have not even have heard of those words before. So I'm going to lead through the practice. After the introduction, I will lead us through. So you don't have to sort of remember everything I'm going to say. Metta Bhavana is one of the two practices that we teach within our movement. So meditation practices. It's usually a 5-stage practice. We're going to do a slightly unusual version of it today. So we're going to do a 4-stage version, which I'll describe shortly. And in what we're going to do is actually we're going to go back online in the 3rd stage. And we are going to, we'll just hear from some of the members of our order. And what they're going to be doing is actually rejoicing. So there's another practice within our movement of talking about each other's good qualities. So talking about each other's positive qualities. And it can be a very sort of good foundation for kindness and for love, because that's what we're cultivating in the practice. So that's the slightly unusual sort of setup we have today. So I'll just describe the other stages of the practice that we'll do today. So the first stage, which will start shortly, we cultivate metta for ourselves. So the word metta is quite difficult to translate. That's why we use the original sort of Pali language. One way of translating it is well-wishing or love or kindness. So what we're doing in the practice, starting with ourselves, is we are cultivating well-wishing, cultivating love and kindness towards ourselves. So that's where we start with the practice. We're going to keep the practice quite simple today, I think. So what we'll do, and I'll drop these in as we go through, we're just going to drop some traditional phrases in silently to ourselves to help us cultivate this well-wishing towards ourselves. So the phrases are, may I be well, may I be happy, may I be free from suffering, and then may I develop and grow. So yeah, we can just drop those phrases in just one by one. It's a bit like sort of dropping a pebble into a pool. So we just drop a phrase in silently to ourselves, may I be well, and we just sort of see what ripples out from that. Yeah, so that's the first stage, cultivating well-wishing towards ourselves, okay? The second stage, we will cultivate metta, well-wishing for a friend. So it's good just to think of a sort of straightforward friend connection you have. Don't worry too much about sort of choosing the right person. You can just sort of choose someone you've got a straightforward well-wishing for. And yeah, in the second stage, we just bring that person to mind and we wish them well. Again, we can use the phrases, may they be well, may they be happy. Yeah. The third stage of the practice, we normally call the neutral person stage. So we bring to mind someone we don't know, someone we don't have a strong connection with. As I say, we're having an unusual version of that today. So we're going to be listening, we open our eyes, we'll listen to these rejoicings within our, between friends online. And we can just sort of take it in. So in a way it's sort of different to the meditation. So that will happen. There's going to be 7 people who talk for just a couple of minutes each as part of that. So for those in the room, we can just take that in. Yeah. And then at the end of that, we'll close our eyes again, we'll go back into the meditation, and we'll basically extend the metta, as this well-wishing, as far as we can. So metta is universal loving kindness to all beings. So, and I'll lead us through that, but we can just sort of expand our metta, our well-wishing, as far as we can take it in that final stage. So, okay. So that's what we'll do. I hope that's clear enough. So let's prepare in the room for the meditation. Let's prepare online for Metta Bhavana. So international Metta Bhavana. So yeah, just settling into meditation posture, just whatever's comfortable. So what we're looking for in the posture is this sense of being able to relax, let go, but also a sense of uprightness in the body. You know, whether we're sitting on cushions or a chair, whatever our setup, the sense of uprightness in the body, but being relaxed. Yeah, when you're ready, closing your eyes. And as I lead us into the Metta Bhavana practice, this cultivation of loving kindness, I'll just start by just leading us through some body awareness. So just a sense of helping us to settle into the posture. So we can start by just bringing our awareness to the contact with the ground. Seeing what we can feel in our feet. So there might be sensations of heat or cold, might be tingling inside the feet. Just seeing what you can feel of the sensations of the feet. Then the lower legs and the knees. Just checking you're not holding on in the big thigh muscles. So see if you can let go even more fully into the cushion or chair beneath you. So really feeling the effects of gravity. Letting go into the great earth. Then the upper half of the body, a sense of uprightness. So the chest is opening. Shoulders are falling away from the ears. Just seeing if there's any areas of tension in the body. So bringing a kindly awareness to the belly, often an area where we hold tension without fully realizing. So we can allow the belly to be soft. Allow the face and the hands to be soft. And now just tuning into the heart center inside the chest. So So seeing if you can feel any sensations in the heart center, inside the chest. And if you get lost in the practice, the mind wanders off. That's what the mind does. You can just notice that. And this can be a good place to come back to, the heart center inside the chest. Connecting with a sense of well-wishing. We go into the Metta Bhavana practice. So in the first stage of the practice, we cultivate metta, well-wishing, kindness towards ourselves. So we can, one way into doing this is to say the phrases silently to ourselves. May I be well. May I be happy. May I be free from suffering. May I develop and grow. So we're tuning into the natural well-wishing we have for ourselves and natural self-cherishing. May I be well. And if our mind wanders off, we just notice that with a kindly awareness. We come back to the sensations in the heart center inside the chest. We come back to cultivating metta, well-wishing for ourselves. Now in the second stage of the practice, we cultivate metta, well-wishing, for our good friend. And we just tune into the natural feelings of well-wishing we have for our friend. And we can drop in the phrases silently to ourselves in our minds. May they be well. May they be happy. May they be free from suffering. May they develop and grow. Again, if our mind wanders, we just notice that with a kindly awareness. We can come back to the heart center inside the chest and back to cultivating metta, love, kindness towards our good friend. May they be well. May they be happy. May they be free from suffering. May they develop and grow. Okay, so now we will go into the rejoicings part of the morning. So you can, if you want to, just stay with your eyes closed, meditating, and just take in what people will say. But I would recommend coming out of a meditation posture and just sitting comfortably, actually, just for this stage. Just relax. Can continue this feeling of well-wishing we've been cultivating. A bit of an echo. I'll just give a short introduction to this part. So we're going to be hearing from seven people in different parts of the world rejoicing in each other. Just for 2 minutes each. And then we'll go back in and finish the meditation. And we're going to start with Varadi. Varadi is actually from Australia, but she's currently in the UK. And I met Varadi very briefly, I think, when she was getting into a car to go off to a 2-month retreat earlier this year. I will hand over to Varadi.
Thank you. Thanks. Hello from Adistana. I get to rejoice in Upekshanandi. I feel a bit moved, actually. It's just so lovely to see you, Upekshanandi, and to be a part of this. I met Upekshanandi on the meditation retreat that was just mentioned. And Upekshanandi, I want to rejoice in your brilliant heart and mind. You have this kind of capacity to, or this great kind of desire to really know how things are, this kind of pursuit of the mystery of life. It's almost unstoppable, but you also have the sense of wanting to provide opportunities for others to do so. And it's this, both of those things are within you, and to be on the receiving end of you creating these opportunities for others to know from their own experience has been a great gift for me. And I've kind of experienced that having been on retreat with you and just spent time with you afterwards. And I just think it's a great gift for the whole of Tri Ratna and the world. And I want to also rejoice in your sense of humor and the laughs we shared, and also your cooking. It's very excellent. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Varadi. Good to see you. Okay, it's quite moving. Give me a moment. Kusala Chita, really lovely to see you, and such a delight to be able to rejoice in you today. Somehow you were the first person who popped to my mind, and we've known each other for just over 7 years. We've met on this beautiful long retreat where you were given a name, Kusala Chita. And you know, I've been so moved over the years just seeing you truly embodying this name, she whose heart mind is skillful. And in fact, your heart, big Amitabha's heart, becomes more and more tender. It becomes so, so tender. And that tenderness has a massive effect on others. And I've been seeing that again and again. And also, it's a true delight to be in a chapter with you, in this online amazing chapter. And you know, you're consistently meeting me with so much compassion and empathy and love and care. I really want to rejoice in that consistency of those qualities that you just keep sharing and sharing and sharing. I always, after seeing you online or chatting with you, I always have that uplift. I feel loved after having spent some time with you. So thank you very much for that. And also, I want to rejoice in your great positivity. There's something of something I really admire in you, that love for life. There's so much love for life and how beautifully you are able to live this life with all it brings, all ups and downs. And in fact, the way you share about meeting, really meeting, not even facing, but meeting your challenges in life with so much care and tenderness. I really learn a lot from the way you explore and meet life so fully and beautifully. So thank you very much for all the inspiration and all your wisdom and all your empathy and that level of sharing you provide in life. You're such a delight to know and to be friend with.
Thanks so much, Pekshanandi. Arianita. It is my very great pleasure to rejoice in you, Arianita. We met in 2017 on that long retreat. We were ordained together. I last saw you in person in 2018 at the Order Convention in Bulgaria. You know, we're a long way away from each other. And we've seen each other occasionally on Zoom and WhatsApp. But I still feel very strongly this very strong connection to you as a dear spiritual friend and Dharma sister. We shared a room together for 3 months at Akashavana, and it was very clear to me very quickly that you are a woman of great confidence and faith in the Dharma and great devotion. And just to say, you are the only non-English speaker on our retreat, and you face that with great courage and equanimity. So you took Ratnasambhava as your yidam, and I just wasn't surprised at all, because you really embody so many of those beautiful qualities of Ratnasambhava. Your steadfastness, you know, you're grounded like the earth, and you really helped me to stay grounded. You're bright and warm like the midday sun. So much generosity and abundance. A couple of things that have really struck me over the years. One was when you and your husband took in a 15-year-old homeless refugee boy during lockdown, and he lived with you for 3 months. Such a generous gift. And I think it was January 2019, you became the chair of the Paris Centre. Now that for me really epitomises your commitment to service and to practice for the benefit of all beings. Sadhu, Arianita.
Thank you, Sister. Thank you. Dear Suvanavira. You were my first Dharma teacher a long time ago now. And immediately I was fascinated by your quiet and joyful strength, something very, very grounded, very solid. And also I was fascinated by the simplicity of your life. It was, wow, something very strong for me at this time. Yes, today I rejoice at you, at your faith, your commitment in the Dharma, and at you like a bodhisattva who went in Moscow alone, a long time ago to spread the Dharma. Thank you, dear Suvanavira. You are an inspiration for me. Thank you for your big smile always. And with my gratitude. Love.
Thank you very much, Arianita. Greetings, everybody from Moscow. And I'd like to rejoice in Arya Ketu. And when choosing Ariaketu, one quality immediately came to mind, a willingness and a readiness to teach the Dharma. Just to give a little context, I'm teaching the Dharma in Moscow, mostly classes online. I can translate into Russian. They're open to Russian speakers anywhere, Russia, Ukraine, Israel, Estonia, Kazakhstan, etc. And there was a time when I thought, well, maybe people here would respond to the approach of an Indian order member. Russia's relatively nearer culturally, geographically to India than Western Europe. And I immediately thought of Ariaketu, which is a quality in itself. And I asked him if he'd like to take a course, to teach a course. And Ariaketu is a busy man. He's founded Arialoka Computer Education. He teaches a lot. He's a busy Dharma teacher in India. And Ariaketu immediately said yes. And not only did he say yes, I'm not sure exactly, I haven't worked it out in terms of time, but it kind of felt like he carried on teaching for about another 18 months, which demonstrates the quality of being willing and ready to teach the Dharma. And I want to thank you deeply for doing that. Ariaketu also has the most beautiful blue shirts that I've ever seen anybody wear as well. So thank you, Ariaketu. Jai Bhim, Namo Buddhaya.
Thank you, Suvarnavira. Thank you very much. It was really very pleasure to teach to the Moscow people. Hello there. Hi, Kemadamma. Very nice to see you. It looks like that I'm just sitting near to you in India. So we just recently met. So it's wonderful memories behind me. So I really rejoicing in the merits of you that you have a really great, warm, you are a very warm-hearted person. So whenever I just meet you, I just enjoy time with you. And I can see that you have a great quality of friendship and generosity as well. So you are a living man with friendship and generosity. I really rejoicing in the merits of your friendship and generosity. As I know you since many years, you ordained with my father, such a Dhamma. So you became the friend of my father, then you become the friend of mine. And now recently you talk with my son. Now immediately, just my son also feel that, he can talk with you very friendly way. So thank you very much. And you also help friends whenever friends are in need anything. And you help them. You travel every year to India, maybe 2 times in a year, and giving your time, giving your energy, and whenever the friend need, you help them financially as well. And I saw that you are giving your whole life, time, energy, and money to help your friends. So you are completely devoted your life for friendship. So I really wanted to rejoice in the merits of your very good quality of friendship. And everybody knows the friendship is the whole Dharma. So here you are, Kema Dhamma. Thank you very much, Kema Dhamma. You have a wish you a very good health and long life. Thank you.
Thank you, Ariaketu. Jai Bhim indeed. Namo Buddhaya. I'm at the end of this chain, and so I don't have a particular individual to rejoice in, but it's only just a couple of weeks or so since my return from India, and so I thought I could just rejoice in the order in India. It certainly needs it. It's a, quite difficult practicing the Dhamma in India and spreading the Dhamma. And Arya Ketu does this very well. But lots of people and lots of my friends. Every time I go back to India, as Arya Ketu says, it's a couple of times a year. And they always ask me when I'm coming in through customs and things, why do you come to India? You know, and I say, I come to visit my friends.
Thank you.
So, and they always ponder. I don't suppose they get that very often. But it's always been the case, and it's something I've always said. I've been going there for 30 years. It'll be 30 years this year. So, and there is something about friendship in India, which is it certainly makes me ponder. This last time, I guess I got hooked up on the word sabhava, which is like asking what is the nature of something. So the Buddha says in the Satipatthana Sutta to contemplate the nature of arising and vanishing. And so it's good to contemplate the nature of a metta. And it's, what can we say? Its ramifications are so broad. And it's led me to this thing of thinking, I really don't understand Kalyanamitrata, particularly the aspect of delight in. And I think, and that's an aspect of metta, I think, often not talked about, is taking delight, even if you don't know. So I'd like to just take delight in well, it's a night time for me, but in the nature of Sangharachita passing us to the metta and allowing us to share all together. So, and so I'll pass you back to, what do we say, Manjusiha. So thank you very much. And Jai Bim to everyone.
London, back in London. So we're going to go back into our meditation now to finish the meditation. So let's set ourselves up for the final stage of this Metta Bhavana practice. And I will thank all of the rejoicers after the meditation as well. But thank you, Kema Dhamma. So I met Kema Dhamma in Bodh Gaya in India. So that's where the Buddha attained enlightenment. So we had a very sort of brief sort of connection there. So Kema Dhamma was in Australia. Is in Australia. So let's prepare for the final stage of the meditation. So again, just settling into meditation posture. Closing our eyes. So in a way, in this stage, what we can do is just let those words just reverberate. You know, we don't need to make great effort in this stage. We can just let the words settle. Tune in again to the sense of well-wishing for ourselves and for others. Well-wishing for those we've just seen on screen. So in the UK, Western Europe, and in Russia, in India, in Australia, perhaps elsewhere as well. In the final stage of the practice, we extend this well-wishing to all beings. So perhaps we can start this stage with bringing ourselves to mind, our good friends, bringing to mind all of those we've just seen on screen. And seeing if you can cultivate well-wishing equally for all of those people, including ourselves. May they be well. May they be happy. May they be free from suffering. May they develop and grow. And then we can cultivate metta for all of us in this room. And what I mean by the room is the room here at the London Buddhist Center, but also the room that's on Zoom as well. So we're all meditating together. We can extend that metta throughout that space. This international space. Then we can imagine the four walls of this space, this virtual and real space. We can imagine the four walls falling one by one. And we bring more and more beings into this field of metta, this field of well-wishing that we've been cultivating. So seeing how far we can extend our well-wishing. Around the world and into the universe. May they be well. May they be happy. May they be free from suffering. May they develop and grow. And now we can drop any effort we've been making in the practice. We just continue to sit still and we just sit for a few moments, just absorbing the practice, absorbing the words, sensations. So just a short period of just sitting, doing nothing. And then when you're ready, opening your eyes, coming out of the meditation. Okay. So great. So I'm just going to say just a few more words, mainly of thanks, and then I'm going to hand over to Jnanadara in his magnificent bow tie, which I'm seeing close up now for the first time. Thank you all in the room for being part of this unusual Metta Bhavana practice. I hope it was enjoyable and fruitful for you. I just wanted to say, if you're new to Metta Bhavana, hopefully it gives you a taste of Metta Bhavana, but I hope you'll come and learn the traditional five-stage practice as well. So we teach, as I say, that's one of the main practices that we teach here at the Buddhist Center. The theme of the Tri Ratna Day today that we're celebrating is partly transformation. And, you know, Metta Bhavana is incredibly transformational practice. Hopefully you've got a sort of flavour of that from this brief, unusual sort of session we've had together. It's a practice that transforms our relationship to ourselves and to the world. Really encourage you to explore the practice much, much more fully, whether you're new or, you know, you're familiar with the practice. Yeah, really transformational practice. The other thing I'll say is, just to particularly thank those who are online rejoicing and anyone online meditating with us. So thank you very much for joining us at the London Buddhist Centre. And I'll just read the names of those who were rejoicing in each other. So Varadi and Upekshanandi, Kusala Chitta, Aryanita, Sivana Vera, Aryaketu, Kemadama. So you got a sense of where some of those people were. So Sivana Vera, for example, in Moscow, Kemadama in Australia, Aryaketu in India. So again, it's just a little sort of snapshot of our order and movement. Partly to do with time as well. So it's still middle of the night in the Americas. So we didn't have people from Mexico or the States or, you know, Venezuela. New Zealand, it's sort of quite late. So not many people from there. We were joined by Surya Gupta. Just a snapshot of our order and movement that we're celebrating the anniversary of. So thank you all. I'm going to hand over to Jnanadara.
So all that's left for me to do is just to thank you, Manjusiha. You've thanked everybody else. Thank you so much for leading the Metta Bhavana so beautifully. Thanks also to the London Buddhist Centre for collaborating with us on this international festival. If you're online, stay on the line, as it were. We'll hear a little bit from Future Dharma Fund. Just for those of you in the room, Future Dharma Fund, in a way, is trying to make the Dharma available to more and more places. So we've heard from a few friends in a few places. So, you know, we've got a presence here in the UK, Tri Ratna does. We've got a presence in certain countries in Europe. We've got a big presence in India and also the Americas. But there's lots and lots of places where we don't have a centre. There's lots and lots of places where people who could benefit from what we do don't benefit from what we do because they just don't know that the Dharma even exists. So what Future Dharma Fund is really about is spreading the Dharma more widely around the world and creating the conditions to do that, particularly fundraising. What I'm going to do is we're going to finish our session here at the London Buddhist Centre. So just in a moment, there'll be tea served, and you're more than welcome to stay around for a cup of tea. And what we'll do is we'll say goodbye to those of you online. But if you're online, don't go away because you're going to hear from Nandavajra in just a moment. So bye from us from the London Buddhist Centre. Join us in what will it be in about an hour and 45 minutes. We're actually going to do a tour of the London Buddhist Centre and show some of the other places around the centre. And for those of you in the room, there's four more sessions for Tri Ratna Day. So if you might like to go home. And if you look up Tri Ratna Day online, you might be able to join and see some of the other things that are going on in the rest of the day. I won't tell you what they all are now, but you can see all that online. So thanks very much to the London Buddhist Centre, to Manjusiha, and bye from us from now. But if you're online, please stay on the line and we'll see you soon.